Onision, I'm worried about you, man. If you don't calm down a little bit, you're gonna end up as one of those people who die in their 30s from a burst brain aneurysm or something.
Hell yeah, I'm self-righteous. I don't murder anything.
Well, neither do I, since the definition of murder applies to humans. But for the sake of argument, I'll ignore that you misapply murder and genocide to animals, because I think that, it's been pointed out already, and it's really just a matter of semantics anyway.
Well, let's see here. We're living beings and we like being alive, right? So if we kill other beings that probably like being alive, that's not really something that we have to debate now, is it?
Wait a second. Say that last part again.
So if we kill other beings that probably like being alive.
Probably? Come on, just say it. You have no clue whatsoever what animals like chickens and cows are thinking. And if you do, please give me some evidence that these animals understand the concept of life, and that they actually have some sort of opinion on whether they care to be alive or not. Actually, you can just give me some testable evidence that chickens and cows are self-aware. That's really all I need.
Let me tell you what, dude, if someone comes in your house and carves you up and eats you, what are you gonna say about that?
Well, I guess I'd say I'm a human being who has thoughts, feelings, interpersonal relationships. I'm self-aware, and I express a clear wish to stay alive.
I am talking about life and death. I'm sorry you don't appreciate the life of other living beings, but I happen to.
Really? 'Cause it looks like you're living in a house. It looks like your clothes are manufactured in a factory somewhere. You probably have a car, or, at least you take the bus every once in a while, and, all those things in their own way are a detriment to other living organisms. Just think about all the natural animal habitats that have been destroyed just so that you can live comfortably. And I point this out to a lot of ethical vegans, and they usually come back at me with an argument of degree. They say that they don't consider themselves evil because they at least reduce the amount of animal pain in the world. But really, I mean, that's kind of bullshit. If you're going to tell me that I'm not doing enough because I still eat meat, then somebody who, say, lives out in the woods, with no power, no running water, they could make the same exact argument against you.
If you are going to call people who eat meat criminal, then join us because you walk on the ground and kill bugs all the time. Let me ask you something. What is the alternative to walking around? Because as far as I know, making some kind of ground contact in order to get from one point to another is something that I cannot avoid. I am giving you people a simple alternative to eating meat, and you turn me down and say, no, I like murdering, it's cool. So you're right about that. If there's an alternative to walking around, then show it to me. But don't be so profoundly stupid and ask me to do something as to sit in one place for the rest of my life.
Okay, I've got a simple solution. Just carry a broom around with you and sweep the path in front of you wherever you go. There's millions of Janes that do this all the time. I mean, I'm not gonna do that because I value the life of insects, about as much as I value the life of grass. But, you value insect life, so yeah, I mean, why aren't you doing this already?
What about eating fish? I mean, God put fish on this earth. Okay, stop right there. Listen, chum, if you're gonna respectively argue something that's based on facts, not fiction, you might not want to include God in the mix. And then they go on to say, in my religion, animals are killed. Whoops, stop, you just mentioned religion again. Congratulations, your argument is pointless.
I mean, I criticize religion all the time, but listen to yourself. You sound exactly like a stereotypical angry preacher. Here, I'll play the clips for you.
So boo-hoo, I have to crack a few eggshells in order to save a few thousand lives. I'm not killing anyone, but I'm a prick. I'm trying to show you the truth. I'm trying to show you the better way. Maybe you get upset and maybe you get your feelings hurt, but I guarantee you, once you take the better side, once you see the light, the truth for what it is, you'll thank me. Seriously, if you're a meat eater and anything bad happens to you, whether you get a burn or your arm cut off, I'm not gonna feel sorry for you. Let me ask you something. If you murder animals on a regular basis, do you really think I give a fuck about your opinion? Today you can become a person who deserves sympathy. You acknowledge that I'm the good guy and you're the bad guy. Something so insanely fucked up about your minds is that you know you're wrong. You know for a fact you're wrong. You argue that you're not wrong when you know it. If you have any concept of the afterlife, I guarantee you are going to the pits of hell.
I'm guessing you consider the saying, "You catch more flies with honey," somehow immoral.